Welcome in. It is halftime across the state of Alabama for high school football games. What a weekend we have. High school football. We all know about what happens tomorrow for college football, especially right here in central Alabama. High school huddle coming up at 10:15. I'm Ryan Hennessy, your host. Our game of the week is a big one. Hoover against Spain Park. These two teams, they don't like each other. Right now, an update. You can go to our website, WVTM13.com, type in high school huddle. We'll have all the scores across central Alabama. Hoover, Spain Park, 21-14. That game at half. Kerry Osep is there. We'll have a live report coming up tonight. But you go to our website, we have all the games and updated by the second with the scores. Some big games going on. Mountain Brook leading Minor 14-0. That game is at half, or actually in the third quarter. Briarwood Christian 14-7. But I want to get back to the game of the night. Hoover, Spain Park. Hoover 0-2, Spain Park 2-0. A lot of people think Hoover's had Spain Park's number over the last few years. Wade Waltrip comes in, Tim Vakakis for Spain Park. So that's going to be a great game. If Hoover loses, they're 0-3 to start the year. It's been years since they were 0-3 to start the season. But if you look at their schedule, they played an Auburn team that's tough to start, then a team out in Mississippi that's very hard, one of the top teams in the state in Mississippi. So it's a misleading 0-2. But they are winning right now over Spain Park. Mountain Brook, like I said, 14-0. Let's see what other scores we have across the area. Big one in 7A. The Thompson Warriors won four straight state titles under Mark Freeman. They are leading Vestavia Hills. Thompson 7, Vestavia nothing. So that one's very close. We'll highlight that tonight at 10:15 on High School Huddle. But just to see if Thompson can get past Vestavia. They played them close, Vestavia, in the playoffs last year. So trying to figure out if Thompson can keep the ball rolling in this one. Let's see other scores we have around central Alabama. Hillcrest, one of the top teams out in the Tuscaloosa area. They're up 41-3 over Northridge. So Hillcrest Patriots, one of the top teams, and showing it with a 41-3 lead there in the third quarter. Trying to see some more scores here. Homewood is tied with Helena, 10-10. That's at halftime. And like I said, if you want to get our website, WVTM13.com, go to High School Huddle. Updated high school, you can go on your phone. We'll have all the scores throughout the evening. Let's see, we got a few more, then we'll get into the college ranks. Hewitt Trustful, huge lead, 35-0 over Oak Mountain. So that's all Josh Floyd and the Hewitt Trustful Huskies tonight. Clay Chalkville, Pell City, Rush Probst trying to build something. They haven't won a game yet at Pell City. They only won one last year. They took it on Clay Chalkville. Clay Chalkville, one of the top teams in the state, 39-0 over Pell City and head coach Rush Probst. So obviously we know about the high school, and we're going to have a full recap tonight at 10 right here on WVTM for High School Huddle. But what about college? I was just out in Tuscaloosa earlier today. What an environment it is. College game day there. Texas coming to town. Steve Sarkisian will pop up the matchups for high school, or excuse me, for college. Alabama and Texas. Last year came down to a field goal. We all know it was hot at Texas. Hopefully the weather's a little bit nicer. A 6 o'clock first kick from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, and that is going to be electric. Our WVTM 13 cameras will be there. Myself, along with our chief photographer, Todd Eagle, will be at that game. And the Auburn Tigers, a later game for Auburn, going out west to Cal. Hugh Freeze explained he did not like the fact that they scheduled this game. What's the point, he says, of scheduling a game all the way on the West Coast, different time zone, really going to mess with his players. They're trying to do different things to get out there to adjust. Cal, sneaky good team. Fun little story, and we'll have more of that tomorrow morning on WVTM 13. But the Cal quarterback grew up with Peyton Thorne, and Peyton Thorne texted him before. No response by the Cal quarterback. So they said they're best friends, but not this week. Auburn hoping to get another win in the win column. UAB, they're going on the road. The Blazers, 1-0. They got their win last Thursday in their home opener. Now on the road against Georgia Southern. And Georgia Southern is a dangerous team with Clay Helton at the helm. He was a USC coach. Now he's at Georgia Southern. So Trent Dilfer, his first road game. We'll see if the Blazers can get it done on the road. Some more games. Let's go. I believe Jacksonville State. They had that week zero win. So now they're 2-0. Taking on Coastal Carolina, a new coach for Coastal Carolina because their coach left to go to Liberty. So this one will be interesting. Jacksonville State, first year in Conference USA. Can the Gamecocks get it done? Their first road test of the season against Coastal Carolina. Some more games. Sanford Bulldogs, wow. Talk about offense by Stanford, I believe it was 69-14 in their home opener on a Thursday night. Now they're on the road against Western Carolina. So that one will be interesting with Chris Hatcher and his team heading on the road. I believe we had one more graphic. There it is, Miles. The Golden Bears of Miles taking on Alabama State. Sam Shea came in last year. They won one game all year. This year, they've won one game and only played one game. So they've matched their total so far. They played Alabama State last year at the beginning of the season. Played them tight. It was a good game, but they couldn't get the win. So this one will be interesting. Miles, I was told, is a quarterback who Sam Shea told me is 6'2", and I think he said like 270 pounds. So he can run, he can throw, he can do it all. So Sam Shea in year number two, the former Alabama Crimson Tide strong safety, played some NFL football, just like the head coach at Alabama State, Eddie Robinson Jr. So those two know each other well, and they're going to be taking on each other down in Montgomery that game tomorrow. So a lot of things happening, obviously, at the college level. We have college game day tomorrow morning from Tuscaloosa. Tim Tebow is in the building. That's for SEC Nation. That's also happening. There's a concert. That's going to be Dan and Shay and then Taylor Hicks. So much going on. This is what college football is all about. But we've got high school tonight as well. A lot of scores to get to starting at 10:15. Join us for High School Huddle.